Hi everyone, my name is Anaiya Raisinghani and I am an Associate Developer Advocate over here with MongoDB. MongoDB Atlas Vector Search was just recently released, so let's dive into a tutorial on how to properly model your documents when utilizing vector search to truly revolutionize your querying capabilities. Since vector search is new, let's first go over an introduction to data modeling in MongoDB before we incorporate our vector embeddings. So data modeling really revolves around organizing your data into documents in different collections. The structure of your data model is actually going to depend on your use case or your project, but there are some commonalities that every developer should know. These are choosing whether to embed or reference your related data, whether or not to use arrays inside of your document, and whether you need to index your documents. For a more in-depth explanation and a comprehensive guide of data modeling in MongoDB, please check out the article that's linked in the description below. Now let's dive into an example of setting up a data model inside of MongoDB. We are going to be building our vector embedding example using a MongoDB document for our MongoDB TV series. On my screen here, we have a single MongoDB document representing our MongoDB TV show without any embeddings in place. As you can see, we have a nested array featuring our array of seasons, and within that, our array of different episodes. This way, in our document, we are capable of seeing exactly which season each episode is a part of, along with the episode number, the title, the description, and the date. Now that we have our example set up, let's incorporate vector embeddings and discuss the proper techniques to set you up for success. So let's first understand exactly what vector search is. Vector search is the way to search based on meaning rather than on specific words. This comes in handy when querying using similarities rather than searching based on keywords. When using vector search, you can actually query using a question or a phrase rather than just a word or two. So in a nutshell, vector search is great for when you can't remember the name of that specific movie, but you can remember the climax or the plot. This process happens when text, video, or audio is transformed via an encoder into vectors. With MongoDB, we can actually do this process using OpenAI, Hugging Face, or other natural language processing models. Once we have our vectors, we can upload them into the base of our document and then conduct vector search and search for whenever we like. Please keep in mind the current limitations to using vector search and how to properly embed your vectors. You are able to store your vector embeddings alongside other data inside of your document, or you can store them in a new collection. It is really up to you, the user, or the project goals. So now let's go over what a document with vector embeddings can look like when you incorporate them into your data model using the same data model as before. Here we have our vector embeddings classified at the base of our document. Currently, there is a limitation where vector embeddings cannot be nested in an array in your document. So please ensure your document has your embeddings at the base the way we do here. We have various tutorials on our Developer Center, our YouTube channel, and in our documentation that can help you figure out how to embed these vectors into your document, along with how to acquire these vector embeddings in the first place. And everything will be linked in the description below. So now let's head into a little extra portion, and that is indexing with vector search. When you are using vector search, it is necessary to create a search index so you are able to be successful when using semantic search. To do this, we have examples inside of our vector search documentation, but I'm also going to go over some skeleton code with you all right now. So here is a skeleton code provided by our documentation. When setting up your search index, you want to change the path to be your vector path. In our case, it would be vector embeddings. Type can just stay the way that it is. For our number of dimensions, please match the dimensions of the model that you've chosen. This is just the number of vector dimensions, and the value cannot be greater than 2048. This limitation actually comes from the base embedding model that is being used, so please ensure you're using a supported LLM or large language model, such as OpenAI or Hugging Face. When using one of these, there won't be any issues running into vector dimensions. And then for similarity, please pick which vector function you want to use to search for the top k nearest neighbors. So now it's time to go over another extra tidbit, which is querying with vector search. When you are ready to query and find results from your embedded data, it is time to create an aggregation pipeline on your embedded vector data. So to do this, you can use the $ vector search operator, which is a new aggregation stage inside of MongoDB Atlas. And it really helps execute an approximate nearest neighbor query. So for more information on this aggregation operator, how to use vector search, and everything else discussed inside of this tutorial, please check out our Developer Center and our YouTube channel for more information. I'm also going to be linking everything in the description below. So thank you so much for watching and for following along.